Solar is so hot these days. No pun intended. Everyone is talking about it, and you always read articles about how solar power is the new thing, and everyone's going solar. Well, people feel this way because solar is first and foremost clean. It takes energy from the sun and uses silicon cells to convert it into energy. There are no emissions, and the sun's energy is free. So how exactly does it work? Well, the sun releases energy in the form of photons, which is a form of energy. When the photons hit the silicon atoms of the solar panels, they transfer their energy to the electrons and then knock them off of the atoms. These excited electrons are like little kids on caffeine. They need a place to go. But that's only half the battle. The solar cells need to convert these electrons into usable power. This is done by an electrical imbalance, similar to the previous video of how batteries work. There are two types of silicon inside the solar panel sandwiched tightly together. One is the N-type, which has extra electrons, and the P-type, which has missing electrons. When the N-type electrons travel to the P-type, an electric field is created. This is because silicon is a semiconductor. When this process happens, which happens in a fraction of a second, the solar cell is ready for the sun. The photons hit both silicon types, which excites the electrons and lines them up to go to work. The electrons move from one layer to another in the same direction, and as we learned earlier, when electrons move, we get electricity. The electrons come out of the metal contacts at the end of the solar panel, and thus act as an energy source. So how much power does solar energy actually provide? Well, power is measured in watts. For example, if you look at your household light bulb, it'll be measured in watts. That's a measure of how much energy the light bulb uses. Solar panels, since they generate power, are measured in watts as well. Now let's talk about the math of solar. Sunlight is measured in surface area, and it produces about 1,000 watts, or 1 kilowatt, per square meter. That's actually a lot of power. But the typical silicon solar cell can only convert 10 to 20% of that sunlight into usable energy. There are some that go as high as 30%, but they are very expensive. Let's say 150 watts for the sake of simplicity. This means that a 1 meter by 1 meter solar panel can power about 10 15 watt fluorescent light bulbs continuously. That is, until the sun goes out. So is that a lot of energy? Well, not really. While solar energy is a growing trend, especially in America, critics say that it's not very practical because of its size. They take up a lot of space and are not very efficient. Another is also the reliability. First and foremost, it works only during the day, so you need batteries to store that power. That means it gets to be more expensive. Another criticism is that solar panels need to directly face the sun. Sometimes the wrong angle can cut the power a solar panel generates to as much as 50%. And that's how solar panels work. If you missed any of my other Kipkay tips, click the end cards on the screen to check those videos out. More Kipkay tips next week. Thanks for watching.